Hi, everyone, and welcome to this episode of Sip and Sync with Azure. In this one, we're talking about personalizing AI applications using generative AI and brain-computer interface. This is extremely cool, and I'm really excited to have invited Govind back on the show, who'll walk us through some of this amazing stuff.
Thank you, Priyanka, for having me here again. I appreciate it. And yeah, there's a lot of exciting stuff, so let's get to it.
Let's start with like some example to set the stage. What do we mean by an application like this?
Absolutely. You know, I do think with generative AI and where we're at, it's time to leap forward and think about new immersive experiences with new form factors. You know, we humans evolved to interact with information systems in a different way, I think. And I think with the capabilities that we have that are coming out, you know, imagine like you go to a luxury store, for example, right? And there's a brand ambassador there that deeply knows you, senses your mood, and proactively like suggests you before, you know, you can even think of it, because they're just very seasoned. They can see the subconscious cues. Now imagine building that experience for your information system, for your website, you know, as a digital brand ambassador. And you can do that now.
Great, let's see it.
Yeah. All right, so what I have here is, I do think like we're gonna have new form factors. And this is just one example. It is by a company called Blueberry. And what I have here is when I put it on my head, as you can see here on the screen, it actually captures my blood flow activity. It uses what is called as FNIRS data. And by sending this data, and we'll get to architecture as to how you can build this yourself with our Azure services. But before I get there, I want to show concretely, you know, how you can create these hyper-personalized experiences. So here, you know, as you can see on the left, you know, I have my emotional state that is being captured.
Sad? Well, wow. Okay. I am really happy, okay?
I think I'm nervous because of the because of the setting right now. But I'm sure we will, as we go through the demos, we'll change that. So, you know, let's showcase some possibilities here. So, for example, let's say you want to read some documents, some kind of report that you had the LLM generate. What if it could adjust the reading comprehension based on your brain activity? So maybe in the afternoon, you're not as focused. So it could, the reading comprehension could be at a high school level. But maybe in the morning, you're more focused and have the ability to absorb more richer facts and information.
I need it the other way around, but that's just me.
And that's fine. And it will adapt because it knows your subconscious state. Exactly. Yeah. Or you want to do some mindfulness meditation. You know, it could adjust the narrative or the instructions of the meditation, the music, based on your brain state. Or you might want to just reflect on, you know, how well you've done in a day. We can capture all that, as you can see here, the different moods you were in throughout the day. And maybe you can adjust your calendar and your work life.
You've been angry in the day too.
Yeah, I guess yeah, something must have happened.
It does capture a lot.
It does capture, exactly. And you can reflect, you can add notes to these.
I see you like to be happy too.
Yeah, there you go.
Important point.
Yeah, especially in the morning.
And that's morning for you.
Exactly, yeah. I think for most people, because, you know, especially if you had a good sleep.
Yeah.
And the other thing is about sleep. And when we sleep, you know, we often have these amazing dreams sometimes, especially when we go into that REM sleep. And and oftentimes, you know, we maybe remember that for a day or two, and maybe we share with others, and then we forget about it. But what if you could capture that dream into an art form and preserve it forever, right?
Yes.
And you can do that now.
Okay.
With our multimodal models that can generate, you know, images, photo imaging, or videos like Sora.
Yeah.
You know, you can use that, and essentially, last night, for example, you know, I had this dream of me running around a circle in a multiverse. And by accessing my brain data, and again, this comes in other forms as well. So just to show you, it can come in different, this biosensing device can come in, you know, wearables that you can wear for sleep, etc. So imagine like accessing that exact time when you had that dream, because you can tell by your REM sleep activity when you had certain dreams.
Yep.
And sending that data to the LLM. Surprisingly, it actually captures not just your verbal narrative, but also the state of brain, your subconscious activity. and, you know, puts that into this art form. It can be a video, it can be image. So now you can preserve this dream that you had and share it with others.
Share with others, yeah.
And reflect on it, maybe. And I think
cool.
There's many ways, you know, we can personalize as well. Like imagine, for example, you're in a car, like a self-driving car, right? And, you know, let's say, you know, while, you know, this car is going to drive by itself, and what if the ride quality gets adjusted based on your brain activity? Maybe, you know, it can go in a much more chill-like ride, or the music
gets
adjusted, or the temperature of the car. So there's a lot of, you know, if we can reveal the subconscious preferences that we have to these devices, and we'll show into architecture how you can do that with Azure services. I think
pretty powerful.
Very powerful.
Very, very powerful. Okay, let's see how it's all built with Azure services.
Yep.
It sounds really complicated because it sounds like there's lots of agents involved and a lot happening, which I'm excited to see how you built it.
Yeah, absolutely. And it's not super complicated at all. I mean, it would help to have a device like this. Mm-hmm. There are other ways to also reveal these subconscious preferences. There are APIs like Hume, et cetera, that can look at your voice and understand how you're feeling as well. And you can actually ensemble all of these signals. You know, here we have, for example, maybe a golf hat that captures signals there, or in this case, my glasses. These biosensors here are transmitting via my phone to, in this case, Event Hub's Kafka. And then from there, it can go to Cosmos. And from there, I have a Azure Functions service that is also an MCP server. It's very easy now to take any Azure function and make it an MCP server.
Yeah.
And then when you interact with the LLM, it can call this MCP server in Azure Functions, which can transmit the FNIRS data.
Yeah.
And that's what we have here. So we have a bunch of these agents, and the meta agent is done in type agent. And then you have other sub agents, like the guided meditation agent, or the designer agent, or deep research agent, that work with other models, whether it's GPT-4 Omni, or DALL-E 3 diffusion model, or even a reasoning model like O3 Mini, et cetera. It can then be combined with our AI agent service and other Azure services like AI search, et cetera, to ground itself. And then, you know, it can generate these outputs that are extremely hyper-personalized that capture that rich subconscious state that you have in mind. Yeah.
Awesome. Yeah, it didn't seem as complicated that as I thought it would be. So how do folks, if I'm sure many of us are interested in trying this out, the demo that you've built. How do we get started? What are some of the code resources that we should be aware of?
Well, the cool thing is we have open sourced all of this, and we'll put the link below. So feel free to go to that open source repo. If you don't have this device, that is okay. We have a stub there, so you can just quickly spin it up, and you can kind of see how all these Azure services work together to create magic.
Awesome. Thank you, Govind, for walking us through that. That is really amazing, kind of mind-blowing. And that's kind of where agentic world sort of, you know, one of the very great applications of agentic AI. With that, we will see you next time. But if you really like this episode, give us a like, subscribe to our channel. Let us know in the comments how you're enjoying the series, and we'll see you next time.